Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. In this video I am discussing complex analysis topic. This is the very important topic for MSc undergraduate students and as well as this very important topic for who are preparing for CSR, NET, KSET, APSET and many other higher mathematics examinations. Okay. I will start with the analytic function. In this video, I am discussing definition of analytic function, CR equations and some few examples and questions of analytic functions. Okay. What is analytic function? In analysis, we know that continuity and differentiability. Yes or no? Okay. Differentiability. Okay. In same way, in complex analysis, in place of differentiability we call as analytic function. Okay, analytic. Okay, analytic function means a complex valued function w is equal to f of z is said to be analytic at point z is equal to z naught if dw by dz is equal to f dash of z is equal to limit del z to 0 f of z plus del z minus f of z by del z. Okay, it exists and is unique at z naught. Okay, analytic function is also called as regular function or holomorphic function. These two words are very important. Okay, usually in CSR, NET and KSET examinations, they used this type of words. Okay, remember these words also. This analytic function we called as regular function or also called as holomorphic function. Okay, next CR equations. This simply we call as CR equations. Okay, what is CR equations? Cauchy-Riemann equation. Okay, W is equal to U plus iota V, then dou U by dou X is equal to dou V by dou Y and dou U by dou Y is equal to minus dou V by dou X. These two equations we call as CR equations. Okay, these two equations we call as CR equations. Okay, next we have some important note. I is equal to root minus 1 or I square is equal to minus 1 and second note is z is equal to x plus iota y. Okay, usually these terms we used in the by solving problems. Okay, first I will start with some few examples. The first question is f of z is equal to z square is analytic or not. Okay, now we have to prove this function is analytic or not. Okay, first question. Okay, they given f of z is equal to z square. Okay, what is z? We know that x plus iota y. Okay, f of z is equal to x plus iota y whole square. Okay, then by using a plus b whole square formula, a square, that means x square plus iota y whole square plus 2 iota x y. Okay, this we get. Okay, then we solving this x square plus what is I square value? I square means minus 1. Okay, minus 1, that means y square plus 2 iota x we get. Okay, this is the we get. Okay, we know that what is f of z? F of z is equal to w is equal to u plus iota v. Okay, u means real part of the real part and V is the imaginary part. Okay, that means we compare with this. What is your U value? U is equal to x square minus y square and what is imaginary part? This is imaginary part 2xy. Okay, now we have to by using CR equations we have to check the given function is analytic or not. Okay, first of all we start with now we have to find the CR equation satisfies or not. Okay, dou u by dou x, differentiate partially with respect to x. Okay, what we get? 2x. Okay, then dou u by dou y, what is dou u by dou y? Minus 2y. And dou v by dou x is equal to 2y. Okay, dou v by dou y is equal to 2x. Okay, we get like this. Then what is the conditions? Dou u by dou x is equal to dou v by dou y. This is 2 are equal. See this. Okay, dou u by dou x is equal to dou v by dou v. This is equal to 2x. And next condition is dou u by dou y is equal to dou u by dou x. dou u by dou y is equal to minus dou v by dou x. It satisfies or not this condition? Yes, this satisfies this equation. dou u by dou y is equal to minus dou v by dou x. Okay, these two are equal. Okay, satisfies the CR equations. Therefore, f of z is a analytic function. This is like we solving the next problem. Okay, next problem is f of z is equal to e power of minus x cos y plus I what sin y. Okay, I am multiplying f of z is equal to e power of minus x inside. What we get? E power of minus x cos y plus iota e power of minus x sin y. Okay, this we get here. What is the real part? U is equal to the second question. The real part is u is equal to e power of minus x cos y. And imaginary part is equal to e power of minus x into sin y. This we get. Okay, now we have to differentiate partially these two. Dou u by dou x is equal to what we get? Minus e power of minus x into cos y. And dou u by dou y is equal to e power of minus x into differentiation of cos y is minus sin y. Okay, then dou v by dou x is equal to differentiation of this function with respect to x. What we get? Minus e power of minus x into cos y. And dou v by dou y, what we get? E power of minus x into cos y. Okay, this we get. These functions are equal or not? Dou u by dou x is equal to dou v by dou y. These two are equal? No, because here we get minus value. We get here minus value. Okay, these two are not equal. Okay, and dou u by dou y is not equal to dou v by dou x also. These two also not equal. Therefore, the given function is not analytic. Okay, next question is if f of z is equal to cos z is analytic or not. Okay, now we have to evaluate the cos z is analytic or not. Okay, next question, f of z is equal to cos z. Okay, now we know that in place of z we replace x plus iota y. Okay, now we have to use the standard trigonometric formulas. That is, we know that cos a plus b formula, that is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Okay, we know that these formulas. By using these formulas, we have to solve this function f of z is equal to, okay, here what is a? Here a is x and b is iota y. Okay, that is cos x and cos iota y minus sin x into sin iota y. Okay, therefore f of z is equal to cos x into cos iota y. Now we have to note down some important note. Cos iota we also written as cos hyperbolic y, and sin iota y is also written iota sin hyperbolic y. Okay, we have to remember this note. Okay, here cos x into cos iota y written as cos hyperbolic y minus here sin x as it is, and sin iota y is written as iota sin hyperbolic y. That means iota sin hyperbolic y. Okay, therefore here what is real part? Here this is the real part and this is the imaginary part. Okay, here u is equal to cos x and cos hyperbolic y, and v is equal to minus sin x and sin hyperbolic y. Okay, this we get. Then we have to find the partial derivatives of this. Dou u by dou x is equal to differentiate with respect to x. Differentiation of cos x is minus sin x into cos hyperbolic. Okay, then dou u by dou y is equal to cos x, and differentiation of cos hyperbolic y is sin hyperbolic y. Okay, then dou v by dou x is equal to differentiation of sin x is cos x minus cos x and sin hyperbolic y. Okay, then dou v by dou y is equal to differentiation of this function with respect to y partially. What we get? Minus sin x into cos hyperbolic y. Now we have to observe this. These two are equal. Dou u by dou x is equal to dou v by dou y, and here these two are equal. Dou u by dou y is equal to minus of dou v by dou x. Therefore, this function satisfies the CR equations. Therefore, the given function is analytic. Okay. Like this we solve the next problem also. Next problem is f of z is equal to sin z is analytic or not. Okay, f of z is equal to sin z is analytic or not. Okay, f of z is equal to sin of x plus iota y. Okay, here also we use standard trigonometric formula, that is sin of a plus b formula. Okay, what is sin of a plus b formula? Sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Okay, we know that this formula. Okay, yes or no? Here what is a? This is a, this is b. Okay, therefore f of z is equal to sin x cos iota y plus cos x and sin iota y. Okay, f of z is equal to, now sin x, according to note, cos iota y is written as cos hyperbolic y plus cos x, and sin iota y is written as iota sin hyperbolic y. Okay, here real part is real part sin x cos hyperbolic y, and imaginary part is cos x and sin hyperbolic y. Okay, now we have to find the partial derivatives. Okay, dou u by dou x is equal to differentiation of sin x is cos x cos hyperbolic y, and dou u by dou y is equal to sin x and differentiation of cos hyperbolic y is sin hyperbolic y. Okay, then dou v by dou x is equal to differentiation of this function with respect to x. What we get? Minus sin x sin hyperbolic y, and dou v by dou y is equal to cos x cos hyperbolic y. Now we have to observe this. These two are equal. Dou u by dou x is equal to dou v by dou y. Then these two also equal. Dou u by dou y is equal to minus of dou v by dou x. Therefore by this function satisfies CR equation. Therefore, this function is analytic. Okay, like this we solve the analytic functions. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like the video and share the video and subscribe my channel. Thank you. In next video, I am discussing harmonic function and harmonic conjugate of the function. Okay, thank you.